This has been an ongoing bipartisan effort for the past 5 years, and we made progress. We have members from both sides of the aisle, both houses, pushing one simple message that local roads matter, that investment in our local infrastructure is important. We've had some success. If you look at the funding for our local municipalities, where they were 4 years ago to where they are now, every town, village, city, county has received at least a 40% increase, some cases a 50%. But that's not enough. There are billions of dollars in unmet needs. And what we're coming together in this bipartisan effort, last week we sent a letter to the governor that was signed by 137 members of the state legislature, 65% of the entire body, 100 members in the state assembly, 37 members in the state senate, bipartisan across the board. And what we're asking in this year's budget to the governor and legislative leaders is for a $150 million increase in the CHIPS base aid that goes right to our, that is unrestricted aid, goes right to our local municipalities so they can spend on their local roads and bridges, and a $50 million increase to the Bridge New York for the local portion of our of the infrastructure for their local roads, bridges, for the bridges and culverts. So I'm gonna, we have a few speakers. I'm gonna get to some other points a little later, but at this time I wanna introduce my senator, our senator Tom O'Meara, who's co-hosting this effort. He is my senator too. And let Tom say a few words. And then we're going to hear from some of the interested parties and who this affects and why this is just a coalition of effort across the board, because this is with the town highway superintendents, county highway superintendents, associated general contractors, Farm Bureau, New York State Association of Counties, New York Conference of Mayors, and Association of Towns. So at this time, I'd like to turn it over to Senator Tom O'Meara.
Thank you, Phil.
You want to make sure we're about to.
Yeah. Thank you all very much for coming out again this year. You know, we do this year in and year out. We have a great turnout. We've got, I think, more members than ever signed on to support letter for the increase in CHIPS funding, the bridge program, the Pave New York program. Our local roads are critically important as we all drive them every day. It's my honor to serve in this legislature with all these colleagues that are here with me today supporting this, but most importantly, my assembly colleague, Phil Pomisano, who has helped me over the last several years with this effort. But it doesn't happen without all you guys that are here. The sea of orange that we have here. Thank you all very much. It's you guys in the orange that do the work day in and day out. And it's you being here every year to help us do what we do. But to have your support behind us, to have this great showing of support, is critically important for us to do what we do. So we got a few speakers here, so I'm not going to belabor the point. But it's just an honor to be amongst all of you today for keeping our roads in great shape, keeping our roads safe, and doing the jobs that you guys and women do day in and day out here. So. With that, we just go into.
Let's go.
I will have our transportation chairman.
Yeah, that's perfect.
Joe Robach.
Joe.
Speak to us.
Thank you, Tom. Thank you very much. We will be very brief. I will add to Tom O'Meara's comments, the vice chairman of the transportation committee. Thank you so much for coming down here. It really is meaningful. If you're down here, and a lot of you people have been down here for years lobbying, you see we have people on every issue, every subject. And this one should get fixed automatically. But like anything else in a democracy, we need you to be down here representing the people all across this state to make sure we do the right thing and get this done. And it's good to let the governor and other people see you all here, because not only do roads matter, but equal distribution of funds and resources matters in a democracy too, and you make that happen. Last year, because of you guys and a lot of other people lobbying, we were able to get parity with the Metropolitan Transit Authority on capital roads and bridges. Wouldn't have happened without you. Give yourself a hand, no question. And on that note, let me say, we have a lot of work to do, but it's very important that we call on the commissioner and the governor. $4.5 billion per that agreement last year of $27 billion over 6 years should be going out the door for roads and bridges. And while there's some projects going on, more money should be going out the door, and we need everybody in the process to help do this. But on this year's budget, I applaud all my colleagues here, and I could tell you every one of them geographically, wherever they're from, knows how important this is. We'll be doing one house budgets now. And in our budget, the Senate budget, we will be increasing CHIPS. We're accepting the governor's bridge program, which actually is very good in terms of distribution, fairness, and parity. So we like that one. And we're going to be adding a lot of other things that you're going to like. They're going to help you not only have relief at the local level, but do your job a little bit better. Because at the end of the day, while it's great that we're all here, don't we want to keep the roads safe for our moms, our dads, our kids, our children? That's what this is really all about. Time to put our money, our money where our words are. And I think this year we have a good chance, even in a challenge budget year, of having very good success, hopefully in a three-way agreement that you'll be happy with, and we can go back to our districts and tell motorists, people, our family, we did a good job taking care of your needs and trying to improve the road infrastructure in New York. So thank you for your efforts, and don't let your foot off the gas pedal till the budget's done. Thank you.
At this time, I'd like to introduce George Spanos. He's the president of the New York State County Highway Superintendents Association. George.
Thank you. I would like to open my remarks by saying thank you to the governor and to the state elected officials for your efforts to finance our infrastructure. Unfortunately, this year's proposed executive budget does not meet the needs of our local roads and bridges, and we are here today to once again say local roads matter and to validate our request for the additional funding. Infrastructure funding should be first and foremost at the level that ensures the safety of our traveling public. Then funding should be sufficient to provide an infrastructure that is reliable for commerce and encourages economic development and growth. Adequate funding is needed to decrease the number of deficient bridges. Adequate funding is necessary to improve our road pavement conditions. The deficient bridges in New York State is over 30%. Our highways are only fair to bad about 48%, and those numbers are unacceptable. And we need the additional funding of $150 million for the base for CHIPS and the $50 million for Bridge New York to improve the road bridge conditions. We applaud all the 137 of our state elected officials who have already signed the support, an increase of the $150 million that we are requesting in our letter. And we are grateful to Senator O'Mara and Assemblyman Palmisano for leading this campaign, and thankful to the many people that have showed up today here to raise their voice and to participate in our grassroots campaign. Thank you to all the members, and just remember, local roads matter. Yeah.
At this time, I'd like to introduce the president of the New York State Association of Town Superintendents of Highways, Mike Basil.
Yeah, Mike. All right.
Well, thank you. Thank you for so much support here today. My 12th year coming here to our Advocacy Day event, and look at this. I mean, we're going to outgrow this space pretty soon, too, I think. So
yeah.
give yourselves a hand, all you guys. Again, I'm Mike Basil. I'm the president of Town Highway Superintendents Association. I'm the Town Highway Superintendent and Village Highway Superintendent for the Town of Palmyra and Wayne County. I want to thank all the legislative support we have here standing with us today. Thank you so much, Assemblyman Palmisano and Senator O'Mara, for leading the charge here for us on all of our transportation funding efforts. Special thanks for support I get at home with my Assemblyman Bob Oaks and my new Senator Pam Helming. Thank you. How about Assemblyman Pomisano and Senator O'Meara with 137 signatures on the letter this year, every year. Every year. You keep raising that number. You went over those numbers last night, and we thank you so much. So, our needs are well documented. We have our 2013 Shufan report that our association put together documenting our needs. The state comptrollers put together reports documenting the needs to the tune of over $1 billion in transportation funding deficits. So for far too long, we've neglected our infrastructure, and our nation's approaching 250 years old. You know, we've heard $1 trillion transportation bills coming down the pike. We need more of that money to keep coming down to the local levels. At the current funding levels, towns and villages are not able to keep pace with these deteriorating conditions. We greatly appreciate the new programs, the Bridge New York and the Pave New York programs. Those are excellent programs. We'd like to see $150 million additional dollars go into the Base CHIPS program, not Pave New York, but the Base CHIPS program, and an additional $50 million to go into the Bridge New York program. Huge need for Bridge New York. 5 to 6 times the funding level requested in applications. The need is well documented. In the meantime, you know, we got to keep coming here looking for your support behind us here. 137 legislators and counting, hopefully next year. So again, thank you for being here today, and thanks for all that you do.
Ready? Thank you. Thank you for those great words. And now on the theme of local roads matter, we'll hear from our most local senator, Kathy Marchione.
Thank you. Thank you so much. To say that it's a pleasure to be here is an absolute understatement. I actually look forward to this day all year when the men and women who come down, who care for our roads and do the tough work, come down and ask us for funds. We should be listening. And it's terrific to see that we all are listening. I had an opportunity to visit with the folks from my district this morning, and many, many of them came down. And a perspective that I think we need to focus in on is not all of our roads in New York State are paved roads. In my district, one superintendent told me he had 80 miles of dirt roads. And I said, well, you didn't have to use as much salt this year. And he said, yes, we used more salt this year than we've used in the past. And when I have dirt roads, I use 3 times as much salt. And now I have what looks like a bowl in my road, and I have roads that are impassable. I had another school superintendent who showed me a map, and the map said that New York roads are an orange color. There's only one worse, and that's red. We need to continue putting our money into our infrastructure, into our roads. It does matter. Local roads matter. Thank you all for being here today. Thank you to my colleagues for your support.
We can't overemphasize enough the bipartisan effort of this, and you know, being in the assembly, we have a lot more Democrats than Republicans, but the support has been overwhelming. And Jose Rivera was here videoing her earlier. He was one of the sign-on to the letters. Aileen Gunther is here, and you know, she's been a part of this from the beginning. Aileen, I'd love to have you say a few words just to talk about the importance of this.
So first of all, I just want to say that I'm Aileen Gunther, and I represent Sullivan and Orange County, a very, very, mostly a rural area. And part of my job is traveling on roads from town, to village. And I want to give a shout out for the safety that you provide, each and every one of you, fixing our roads every day. And it's my responsibility as somebody that represents the state of New York to make sure there are additional funds to keep our roads safe, to make it a better New York State. You know, we talk about economic development, we talk about tourism. If our roads aren't kept in an appropriate way, it won't happen. So I support you 100%, and I also thank you for what you do. Thank you.
With the property tax cap, it's hard for our local municipalities to make this type of investment without this type of help. We all know sometimes for some municipalities, the CHIPS funding is the only money they have to do their local infrastructure. And we have some representatives from our local municipalities. Wade Trammell, the general counsel for NICOM, is here. Wade?
Good morning, everybody. My name is Wade Beltramo. I'm general counsel for the New York State Conference of Mayors. We represent the state, city, and village governments. I want to thank the assemblymen and senators and everybody who is here today showing their support for local government and this important issue. I don't want to repeat a lot of the arguments that are, or statements that were already made, but clearly there are a couple of things that I do want to stress. When we talk about local roads and money for local roads, what are we really talking about? We're talking about money for local development. Quality roads, good roads are a key bedrock issue for developing our local economy, for attracting businesses, for attracting jobs, and keeping those businesses and jobs in the state of New York. So that's one way to think about it. The other way to think about this aid for both the CHIPS program and the Pave NY program and the Bridge NY program, which are great programs, we can't thank you enough for support in creating those programs, is that this is property tax relief. Aid from the state is a tremendous way to help local governments keep control on their property taxes and help the local businesses and residents stay here in the state of New York. And so to that end, and I don't want to keep everybody here today, we really want to drive that home. These are important to local governments and the communities they serve. It's not just about roads, it's about safety, it's about jobs, it's about businesses, and it's about lowering our property taxes. So thank you very much, everybody, for supporting us in this endeavor, and we look forward to working with you to get this passed through the budget. Thank you very much.
I don't know if Steve Aquario from NYSAC is here. Is anyone from NYSAC here? Oh, no? Okay. I'd like to actually, obviously agriculture is our number one industry in the state, and having a safe, reliable infrastructure to get our products to market, to help our agriculture community, our farmers, is important. A representative of the State Farm Bureau, Jeff Williams, is here. Jeff?
I just want to, first of all, thank everyone here for the invitation to speak here on behalf of agriculture. I want to thank the people behind me for supporting farming, because I'm seeing a lot of orange shirts that like to eat, definitely. So local roads and bridges are critically, critically important to farms in the state. When it takes roads, that we need the roads to transport our equipment. We need bridges with higher weight limits so we can get dairy products off our farms or milk trucks onto our farms. This is an everyday, very, very critical issue for all of us in the agricultural industry. I want to thank everyone here for pushing this issue. We are right behind you. I promise that, because local roads definitely matter to farms. Thank you very much.
They support local breweries.
Gary Geis, from the Executive Director from the Association of Towns.
Good morning, everybody. On behalf of the Association of Towns, we represent 932 towns in the state of New York, and we want to expressly thank all the legislators here today, and of course, all our highway folks, and Senator O'Mara and Assemblyman Palmisano for orchestrating this event. You know, towns maintain 60,000 miles of roads in the state of New York. More than half of the center line miles in the state are town and local roads. Roads are the number one expenditure for towns. We spend $1.4 billion on local roads, but we only receive $130 million in CHIPS. So we welcome this opportunity to get extra monies in the budget. Without these fine folks in the legislature supporting local government and town highway superintendents, we would barely get anything done. So their support is critical, and we welcome everybody coming out today, because as a former town official, roads is the number one expenditure of money in a town budget. It is critical for the maintaining of safety and for people to get to work And it's the number one thing constituents used to tell me how proud they were to live in my town, because our roads and our highway department were the best ever. And I know, and I applaud everybody for coming out today, and let us know how we can help you get the job done in this year's budget. Thank you very much.
Walter Pashlots from the Associated General Contractors. Is Walter here? No? AGC? Okay. All right. I do want to recognize a former colleague of ours, Dan LaSquadro, who served in the assembly with us. He is now the town highway superintendent of Brookhaven. So let's give Dan LaSquadro a shout out.
I think we're running to the end of Phil's program here. We had enough speakers already, I think. But I just want to thank everybody for being here. Simca Felder has a few words he wants to say. No, he doesn't. But he's here.
Fire him up, Tom.
But he's here. Simca's here from Brooklyn, supporting us here because his local roads matter too. You know, we talk an awful lot in Albany about shared services. And we've got a proposal out there right now that I think a lot of us are not really happy with in this year's budget, because there's nobody in this state that does shared services better than our highway departments. You guys are fantastic at that. Yeah. You share the equipment, you share the labor, you get the job done regardless. And we do need to increase these money. So we're looking forward to supporting that in the next few weeks and getting this budget done. You're helping us a lot in being here today. And I just want to remind everybody, while you're all wearing your orange today, keep it on for noon when the Syracuse Orangemen have their first game in the ACC championship today. So let's make sure we root them to victory. Thank you all so much for being here and helping us do our jobs.
Listen, bring it home, Phil. This fight has just begun. The sea of orange you have behind us represents every town around this state. The legislature gets it. We need the governor to get it. Local roads matter. The statistics
local
are
enough.
Local roads matter. We need the governor to hear that message. We need that sea of orange to be over to the Capitol later to let the governor hear that message. This budget must increase CHIPS funding, must increase funding to our local infrastructure. We need it to go to our local. It's local property tax relief. It's mandate relief. It's jobs. It's safety for our kids who get on the school bus every morning. It's help for our first responders to drive over our local roads. This is what it's about. This is a coalition of support that continues to grow. Democrats and Republicans, Senate and assembly, we're going to do this. The governor needs to understand it. Our legislative leaders will get this. Local roads matter. Let's hear it one more time. Let the governor hear it over at the Capitol. Local roads matter. Local roads matter. Local roads matter.
Local roads matter. Local roads matter.
Thank you for your patience. Thank you for being here.
Good night, everybody.
So thank you for your support. We really appreciate it. And have a great day, everybody.
It's not really our bailiwick.